How many have we lost?
Reaper forces have destroyed approximately 300,000 life pods.
Third of our people.
Alert! Broadside bulkhead cannot be sealed. Hostiles detected.
Then all forces to the north.
You understood that one too?
Yes.
Excellent. Then we have everything we need to open the pod.
I'm transmitting the signal.
Perfect. It'll take a few moments for the life pod to process it. Cerberus has heavy forces incoming. We'll need to hold this position.
Second to catch our breath.
Or set up preparations for the next wave.
Has the life pod ended stasis mode?
It should not be much longer. We should look for ways to hamper the enemy's approach.
I can lay down a singularity to block enemy access.
Got it.
can open the life pod now. There, you've got it. It may take him some time to fully regain consciousness. Be careful, he's confused. Remember, it's been 50,000 years for us, but for him, it's only been...
a few minutes!
No, the bunker is falling. There is no other option.
There are pods online! Those soldiers are still alive!
Their sacrifice will be honored in the coming Empire. Preparing neutron bombardment. Get to your life pod now!
Your nervous system. Enough to understand your language.
So you were reading me while I was seeing...
our last moments. Our failure.
Your people did everything they could. They never gave up. And I could use some of that commitment now.
Shepard, whatever you did got Cerberus interested.
Asari. Human. Synthetic. This is not a good beginning.
It's not safe here. Will you join us?
You fight the Reapers?
Yes.
Then we will see.
A living Prothean?
That's correct, Admiral. But he's not quite what we expected.
Commander, our scientists barely understand what they need to do here. If the Prothean can help us construct this device, we need his cooperation.
Understood, Admiral.
We're losing colonies faster than we can evacuate. We've never seen a force like the Reapers.
He has, Admiral.
Can he help us?
I intend to find out.
Good. Cerberus slipped up and gave us a new weapon. Don't let it go to waste. Hack it out.
Shepard, I need you down in the port cargo hold. It's about our new guest.
I'm on my way. What's the problem?
I've tried to make the room more accommodating, but they're not letting me talk to him.
Apologies, Doctor. Contact protocol with a new species. Assume hostility. We had to dust off the regulations.
But he's not new. I've spent my life studying Protheans.
At ease. I don't think our guest will be a problem. Will he?
That depends on you. I can sense fear in you, anxiety and distress. The Reapers are winning.
What do you mean, you sense?
All life provides clues for those who can read them. It is in your cells, your DNA. Experience is a biological marker.
Then what exactly did I experience back on Eden Prime? That was a hell of a flashback.
The battle left its own mark on me. I communicated this to you. It can work both ways.
Like your beacons.
Yes. Which... You found one. You saw it all. Our destruction. Our warnings. Why weren't they heeded? Why didn't you prepare for the Reapers, human?
It's Commander. And nobody could understand your warnings. The beacon nearly killed me.
Then communication is still primitive in this cycle.
We pieced together what we could, and used it to stop a Reaper invasion 3 years ago.
Then the extinction was delayed.
Now we have your plans for the Crucible. We've started building it.
Crucible?
The weapon your people were working on. I'd hoped you could tell us how to finish it.
We never finished it. It was too late.
Then I take it you don't know anything about the catalyst?
No. I was a soldier, not a scientist. Skilled in one art, killing.
What was your mission?
Among my people, there were avatars of many traits. Bravery, strength, cunning. A single exemplar for each.
Which are you?
The embodiment of vengeance. I am the anger of a dead people, demanding blood be spilled for the blood we lost. Only when the last Reaper has been destroyed will my purpose be fulfilled. I have no other reason to exist. Those who share my purpose become allies. Those who do not become casualties.
Nothing in our fight against the Reapers has been that cut and dried.
Because you still have hope that this war will end with your honor intact.
I do.
Stand in the ashes of a trillion dead souls and ask the ghosts if honor matters. This silence is your answer.
We found this at the dig site. I assume it belongs to you.
It is a memory shard.
Could it help us with the Crucible?
No. It contains only pain. But I will help you fight. And the last thing the Reapers hear before they die will be the last voice of the Protheans, sending them to their grave.
If you don't mind, I have a few more questions I'd like to ask.
Here it comes.
I've written over a dozen studies on your species. I've published in several journals that...
Amusing,
Asari have finally mastered writing.
I'm sorry?
Never mind. What do you wish to know?
We've never seen a species with this sensory ability you have.
It was common among my people. Imparting experience through touch, the chemistry of life. Complicated ideas could be absorbed in seconds.
That sounds very useful.
We evolved as hunters. Reading 1,000 details in our environment ensured our survival.
I'm beginning to understand the beacons a bit more.
Later, we developed technology to harness our ability. Information could be stored in certain objects through touch. Memory has its own biomarker, its own chemistry, as do knowledge and skills. The beacons could remember these things.
Things like Reaper invasions.
Yes, I can still sense the turmoil in you, witnessing the extinction of our empire. The fabric of your being was forever marked that day.
So could you read something about this room?
There was liquid, a form of incubation. The DNA of a Krogan who lived here. He was powerful, prone to violence.
I'm impressed. His name was Grunt.
And if he were my enemy, I would have given him a wide berth. There is great strength in his genes.
Liara here would never forgive me if I didn't ask you. What was Prothean civilization like?
Yes, I've always wondered. What sort of government did you have, and can you tell me about your religious beliefs, or perhaps the...
We are dead now. What does it matter?
I'm sorry. Studying your history has been a lifelong passion of mine.
When I was born, our empire was already at war with the Reapers. The first thing I remember was seeing my planet on fire.
What was your civilization like before the Reaper attack?
We were the dominant race of our cycle. We ruled the galaxy.
My studies indicated you were the only race engaged in space travel at the time. I always found that curious.
We were one empire composed of many subjects. All eventually called themselves Prothean.
What if they didn't want to?
They weren't given a choice.
Are you saying you enslaved the other species?
Any could oppose us if they wished. And if they had won, they would have ruled. Many tried. None succeeded.
I had no idea Protheans were so... severe.
It was by necessity. Very early, we encountered the dangers posed by machine intelligence. They rebelled against us.
We've had the same problem. They're called Geth.
We could not allow the machines to surpass us. It was decided the only way to win was to unite all organic life within our empire.
Did it work?
For a time. The Metacon War. We were turning the tide. Until the Reapers arrived. Then we understood machines had surpassed us long ago, in ways we could never imagine.
Back on Eden Prime, it looked like there were other stasis pods. What happened?
The Empire had fallen, and we knew our cycle was lost. We were the final vanguard, the best soldiers left alive.
So more of you were supposed to survive into this cycle?
Yes. Under my leadership, a new Prothean Empire would have arisen. We would have commanded the races of your time to prepare for the next Reaper invasion. But traitors within our ranks, indoctrinated agents, betrayed us, and the Reapers discovered our plan.
Just out of curiosity, how would you have commanded us?
By leaving you no other option. You would have joined our army, or faced the Reapers alone.
We've uncovered quite a few Prothean ruins. Were you observing our ancestors?
Before the war, we cultivated species who showed potential. Eventually, you would have been offered a choice to join the Empire. But when the Reapers attacked, we ceased all study. We hoped they would see you as too primitive to harvest.
Well, thank you. I think. Is there anything more you can tell us about the Crucible?
Only the stories we heard. They said our scientists were constructing a great machine that had the power to defeat the Reapers.
You never saw it?
By that point, the Empire was smashed into pieces. None of us knew what the others were doing.
Well, if we don't finish it soon, the same will be true of us.
What can you tell us about your own war with the Reapers?
Many of the details were lost. The conflict lasted for centuries. Those that faced the Reapers in the beginning were long dead when I was born. There were memory shards, however, passed down from soldier to soldier. They gave us fragments of what happened.
Several years ago, we found a Prothean VI that called itself Vigil on the planet Ilos. He was the caretaker of a research project.
During my life, Ilos was only a rumor. It was said we had cities there, built on the ruins of a civilization before us, the Inusanon. If our scientists did have a research facility, whatever they were doing was secret.
Yes, Vigil said they wiped all traces of themselves from the records so the Reapers couldn't find them.
The scientists eventually went into cryogenic stasis.
More of my people survived?
No, but they did stop the Reapers from taking control of the Citadel in this cycle. It delayed their invasion.
I never saw the Citadel. It was captured long before I was born.
How did your people wage war against the Reapers?
Attrition. We fought them system by system, planet by planet, city by city. Entire worlds were sacrificed just to slow the Reapers down. Time they spent harvesting a population was time we could regroup.
That must have cost you in the long run.
Yes. Our own people would be indoctrinated, converted, then turned against us. But there was no choice. Mercy is not a weapon. It is a weakness.
Why do you think your own cycle lost the war?
What had been our strength, our empire, became a liability. All races conformed to one doctrine, one strategy. The Reapers exploited this. Once they found our weaknesses, we could not adapt. The subservient races became divided and confused. Then, it was only a matter of time.
I'm happy to say our cycle is different. Most races cooperate, but they still remain unique.
Then it may be your only hope.
Thank you for talking with me. I never imagined actually meeting a Prothean.
This has been amusing.
Oh?
To discover the most primitive races of my time now rule the galaxy. The Asari, the humans, the Turians.
There's also the Salarians.
The lizard people evolved?
I believe they're amphibian.
They used to eat flies. Commander, you may count on me. I am known as Javik.
Then welcome aboard the Normandy, Javik.
You mean the biggest story in 50,000 years that I can in no way talk about?
Say you have seen him. Just wondering.
Commander.
Say that again.
The population of the colony world of Tyvor has been killed.
I don't understand. The Reapers have been taking people alive.
It was self-inflicted. When Reaper forces invaded, Tyvor's colonists detonated nuclear weapons inside their cities.
Goddess.
Their deaths would have been instantaneous, Doctor.
Thank you, Glyph. That'll be all.
Busy?
I have time if you'd like to talk. In fact, I could use the distraction.
What's on your mind?
How long it took the Reapers to eradicate the Protheans, and how long they'll need for us. It took them centuries to conquer the Protheans. We're not quite so widespread, but it would still take at least 100 years. It's selfish, but I keep thinking that if we fail, I'm only 109, Shepard. I could live to see the entire cycle come to an end.
Only 109, huh?
I know. It must seem strange to complain about a 1,000-year lifespan. I used to think it was sad that most aliens live such short lives. Maybe it's not such a privilege to outlive so many. To witness so much death.
Don't drive yourself crazy about this, Liara. We're still in the fight.
Only because you're still driving it forward. We finally have other leaders on our side, but none will take us as far as you can. Sometimes I wonder how you do it.
Every time the world's about to end, I think about how mad you'd get if I didn't stop it. I don't know if I could do this without you.
Flatterer.
I try.
I'll see you soon, Shepard.
At your service. Maybe with an inhibitor. No. Entire catalyzing process would fail. Severe neurological damage. Never mind.
What are you talking about?
Method to extract functional cure without killing you. Many variables. Your immune system compromised. Considering options.
And you have to do it out loud?
Yes. Auditory learner. Need to hear self think. Simulate conversation to promote new ideas. Maximize productivity.
But you're talking about me dying.
Oh, apologies. Medical details causing emotional distress. I hadn't considered effect on patient.
No, it just means I can't sleep.
Doing my best to keep you alive. We'll avoid sensitive subjects. Shepard, how can I help?
Nice talking with you, Morden.
We'll be here if you need me.
I've seen a lot of crazy things in my time on the Normandy, Shepard. A talking Reaper, a talking plant, and now a real live talking Prothean. Hell of a thing, waking up to find everything you know is destroyed. But I imagine the chance to get some payback is consolation. Doubt you and I will ever get a second chance against the Reapers.
Those poor colonists on Eden Prime. First the Geth attack, now Cerberus. For what it's worth, our new crew member doesn't need a translator himself, but he shared a Prothean language tutorial program. It was apparently designed for servant races being inducted into the Empire. Charming cultural clue.
Don't worry, Edie. Once the Krogan are gone, we'll get rid of the smell.
While this body has all factory sensors, I do not have positive or negative associations with any specific scent.
Oh. Well, lucky you. So a Prothean? A real-life Prothean? Has Liara stopped bouncing yet? I'm guessing there may have been some bouncing.
How's our new visitor adjusting to the ship, Edie?
He appears not to understand the human custom of separate-sex restroom facilities. I am attempting to enlighten him. I will update you if there is positive progress.
How about you just update me if he doesn't get the message?
Very well.
Thank you.